Hello dear all, today we are going to discuss about determination of OTR under static sparging and shake flask condition by sulfite oxidation method. Myself Dr. Viral Shukla, assistant professor and head department of microbiology LJIS. So this is just a formal introduction. In an aerobic fermentation process, oxygen is an important nutrient substrate for the growth maintenance and production of metabolites. Oxygen is sparingly soluble in aqueous and fermentation media due to its low solubility. Hence, oxygen needs to be supplied continuously during the fermentation. Oxygen transfer rate into fermentation media and oxygen uptake rate by microorganisms govern the design and scale up of fermenters. Since one has little control on the oxygen uptake rate governed by microorganisms, it is necessary to enhance the rate of transfer of oxygen into the fermentation medium. The transfer of oxygen into liquid is usually accomplished by sparging air or oxygen into the medium. Gas liquid film theory, it can be stated that the oxygen mass transfer rate is limited by the resistance of liquid film surrounding the gas bubbles, which in turn limits the volumetric mass transfer coefficient. So the principle of this practical is dissolved oxygen instantly converts sodium sulfide into sodium sulfate. So the residual sulfite is oxidized during titration against iodine solution using starch as an indicator. Higher iodine titer indicates more sulfite and in turn little dissolved oxygen. मतलब ये है कि sodium sulfate में convert होता है due to the dissolved oxygen. अगर dissolved oxygen कम है तो सोडियम सल्फाइड सल्फेट में कन्वर्ट नहीं होगा जो रेसिड्यूअल सल्फाइड बचा है उसको हम आयोडीन से ऑक्सीडाइज करके टाइट्रेट करेंगे अगर आयोडीन ज्यादा चाहिए आपको उसके ऑक्सीडेशन के लिए तो इसका मतलब ये है कि सॉल्यूशन में डिसॉल्व ऑक्सीजन कम था सो दिस इज द रिएक्शन सोडियम सल्फाइड प्लस 1/2 O2 विल गिव यू सोडियम सल्फेट नाउ द रेसिड्यूअल सल्फाइड That is sodium sulfite plus iodine plus H2O will give you sodium iodide plus H2SO4. This iodine plus starch will give you violet color that will be our end point. These are our requirement, sodium sulfite reagent, iodine solution, 0.1% starch which should be freshly prepared, flask, pipette, dropper, sparger and shaker, not or. The method is like take sodium sulfite solution 50 ml into 3 250 ml flasks labeled as static shake and sparge. Withdraw sample that should be 5 ml from each flask and titrate it against iodine solution using few drops of starch solution as indicator until blue color persists. Note down the titer as A. Leave the static flask at stand still and aerate other two by shaking and sparging for 10 minutes. Similarly, take 5 ml from all the three flasks and measure the dissolved oxygen as shown in step 2. Note down the titer as B. Calculate oxygen transfer rate using the formula. So this is the formula for the calculation. OTR is equal to A minus B multiplied by normality of iodine that is generally 0.1 divided by 4 multiplied by 1000 divided by 5 multiplied by 1 divided by 10 as I have taken 10 minute interval. If you are taking 15 minute, you can divide it with 15. If you are taking 30 minute, you can divide it with 30. Right? So A minus B divided by 2, that will be OTR. And that is calculated in millimolar of oxygen per liter per minute. Thank you guys. Now we will start with the performance. Okay guys, so we are going to perform the practical. I have taken cylinder 50 ml measuring cylinder, right? There's three flasks I have marked with shaking, sparging, and staking. Okay, so I have taken this 150 ml flask, but you have to take it 250 ml. Okay, so I'm going to take the solution, that is sodium sulfite. 50 ml sodium sulfite I'm going to So this is 50 ml sodium sulfite. I'm going to add it in each and every flask. So right now, as we are taking the sample from the same condition, so from any of these three flasks, you can measure the zero hour reading. 0 minute reading. Okay, so I have added. Okay, so I hope you are able to see it. I'm having all these three flasks. So 0 minute reading I'm going to calculate from static one. Okay, so I'm going to collect 5 ml. I have taken 5 ml pipette. Okay, and going to collect 0 minute reading. See, this three flasks we have added with this same sample. So from this three, any one, if I'm going to take a sample of 0 minute, that will be same for all. So we are not going to take 0 minute reading from each and every one. I'm just going to take only for 0 minute. Okay, so this is 5 ml pipette. I'm going to take it in a another flask before starting with the practical. Okay, so now what I have to do, I have to add, this is a start solution. I will take it by dropper. We'll add it 2 to 3 drops of starch. Mix it well. This is iodine solution. And I will titrate it with iodine. You can also use burette for the same. See, the color is already changed, right? So this is my title, that is 6 ml. So for 0 minute, okay, now as we already told, as we already discussed about that, we are going to follow three different conditions. This will be as static. So I will put my flask at stand for 10 minutes. Okay. And other two flasks, this is sparging and this is shaking. So I will put this flask on shaker for 10 minutes. And this is sparger. Okay. This is a sparger. So I'm going to put this pipe into the flask. And I will start with sparging. So I hope you are able to see this. Okay. So for 10 minutes, you have to follow this condition. Okay. So after 10 minutes, you have to stop it. Okay. You have to collect the sample once again, 5 ml. And you have to titrate it. And you have to check the color change. Okay. And then you have to calculate it. A will be, that is your first reading, and B will be your next reading. Likewise, after every 10 minutes, you have to calculate it. Okay. And the calculation already I have given you, the calculation formula. That formula you have to follow for the calculation. I hope you are clear with the oxygen transfer rate method, that is known as sulfite oxidation method. Thank you, everyone.